Garth Brooks.
Hey, how are you guys?
Hey.
Thank you very much.
How are you all?
That's very sweet of you. Thank you.
Who's ever run this, you won't need much of it.
Thank you. Man, yes, please sit down. You guys are great.
We want to be able to see.
Why is everybody standing?
Okay. We just want to be able to see.
Well, I'll get up here with you guys then.
Aaron, do we have anything we have to announce?
No, sir. Over to you.
Nothing at all?
Nothing. I got nothing.
Oh, thank God. I'm the last guy that likes responsibilities. I'm an artist, so, well, I use that term loosely, too. But I love not having responsibilities. And I got to tell you, the last year and a half has not been fun. Hate to say it. And because... And this isn't about today, so do not let me steer today. But I've always been honest with you guys. Your questions used to be, how much new stuff are you going to play versus the old stuff tonight, right? What can people gonna expect? And now everything is about anything but music. So it makes it kind of not fun. But you got to remember, everything that is a blessing is a curse. What has happened is it's made that 2 hours with those people. It's made it fantastic. It really has. And, you know, we do the handshake every night before we go out, the band and I. And I say, look, man, whatever you got going at home, whatever you got going on in your life, leave it outside these walls, because for the next 2 hours, there's nothing you can do about it, right? Let's go out. Let's be selfish. Let's have fun. Let's enjoy ourselves. And, man, I think the crowd is getting that speech as well, because for the 2 hours they're out there, you can see it in their faces, and it's got nothing to do with Garth Brooks. It's got something to do with us being back where we belong, and that's with each other. But what happens now with this recent spike, now everybody's kind of, worrying about, are we doing the right thing? I'm one of them, trying to figure it out as we go. So, again, don't let me steer your questions, but that's where I'm at right now. So I think I got a really bad attitude. I don't know why, because I'm a really up guy. But I think I got a really bad attitude. It just means I'm not grateful enough. It might be just the fact that just want the music to kind of get out there and just get be music again. You know, just get to play and be the stupid free guy that you guys have allowed me to be my whole life kind of thing. So, Aaron, have I already put myself on hold? Or are we good?
No, we're great, boss.
Okay, so here's the deal. What I love about these things is I love to talk with you instead of talk at you. So it works a lot better for me, for anybody who might have been here during the Sprint Center opening, the last trip to the Sprint Center. Before that, Jiminy Christmas, I think there was the, Royale, the Kemper, yeah. Kemper Arena, and then there was the what was the horse show?
American
Royal, thank you. And then before that was Guitars and Cadillacs, I think. So just, it's been a great place for me. My mom was born here, so this is exciting for me. Love it. This is a guaranteed good time. And right now, in this whole thing that's overshadowing everything, what I need is a guaranteed good time. So I'm here more for me than I am for anybody else. I'm just going to be honest there. I'll have more fun than anybody else tomorrow night. I can already promise you that. Jack was the guy that met me out at the airport. He was the guy that was hauling the bags and getting the plane all set up. And I asked Jack, what's the weather supposed to be like? He says, fantastic. So if it's not, Jack. Okay, fair enough. All right, we have any questions? And if we do, if you just identify yourself so I know who I'm talking
to. Sure
about.
Thing. I'm Matt Cleaner. I work for KMBC.
Hey, Matt.
You mentioned you're feeling this tension, right?
Yeah.
This tension of holding the concert during the pandemic. What makes you feel confident moving forward with this concert?
We don't. So we got we have this and we have Lincoln next week. What are we, 100 miles from there? 150 miles from there? So I think there's going to be some people that are here that are going to be in Lincoln next week. I know there were some people in Nashville last week that were going to be here and in Lincoln. And so my thing is, I kind of do everything by karma. Karma is probably a bad word, just fate. A lot of it you got to look at. We got a 3-week window after Nebraska. Right now, confidence, I don't know. You know, as far as the confidence goes. What I do know, and you guys can correct me if I'm wrong, because I'm not a doctor, I'm not a scientist, I just kind of repeat what I hear. But I hear in these other countries, there's this flash kind of happening where it pops up big and then sets down. If that happens here, the 3-week window is perfect for us to assess. And that's what we're going to do. Do I hate the thought of We have five cities after that that's been on sale. Do I hate the thought of pushing them back against? Two of them being Cincinnati and Charlotte, who's been on the books for almost 2 years before the COVID. Breaks my heart to even think about that. But we will address it because, unfortunately, in this world of fun, here's the grown-up part of it, right? So you have to look at it. And you look at it like if it's your butt in that seat, what do you want to see happen? And then, guys, we're just talking about the fans. Try and think about the people who work the stadium. They got people here who take tickets, who do concessions, who are meeting these thousands of people. You got to take care of them. You got to make sure they're safe. Are there going to be enough of them to show up that feel like they're safe? So there's a million things that goes into the equation. My job here is to first follow state rules, which this city's kind of odd because you got both states. Then you're going to follow stadium rules, which, as we all know, state and stadium rules change every day. And then we have our own in-tour rules that we follow as well. My job is to get my people to that show, the band and crew to that show safe, healthy, right? And the people that come in, that's my job to get them there. And then for that 2 hours, 3 hours, let it all go. Have fun. And then my job is to make sure when they leave here, they leave safe, leave happy. And then the most important thing we never talk about anymore is they need to leave the stadium loving each other more than they came here. That's what the music's for. That's the best part. So confident in those things, yes. Music will always be a healer. Music will always be a unifier. Confident in where we go forward from now, I don't know. I don't want to sit on the fence. I don't want to give you a good politician answer where I don't piss anybody off. But just telling you right now, that three-week window will decide for us where we're at. Yes, sir?
Garth, Sean McDowell, Fox 40.
Hey, Sean.
Close friend of John Breslin's, by the way.
Oh, very good. Yes, you picked a good man.
Thank you, sir. Given the uncertain nature of the past year and a half,
yes,
and these 6 weeks, and that you're looking ahead to Lincoln and other places and trying to evaluate whether you can do those shows or not, was there ever a time that this show was in jeopardy?
Yeah, I mean, I think any show, what we did with Vegas is we decided somebody has to take the first step, right? So we did. And I got to tell you, for 2 weeks, it felt good. You were kind of like looked upon as, all right, here's a guy that does it. We had two bands that announced a tour at that point. We were one of them. When Salt Lake City went on sale the next week and set a record for Ticketmaster, forget Garth Brooks, set for Ticketmaster, the quickest sellout, 17 groups announced that next week they were going on tour. So it was a beautiful thing. Now this second wave comes, and now you just deal with it. And as hard as it is, man, think about these frontline workers. Think about these nurses and these doctors that have put their ass on the line for 18, 20 months, and they're just starting to see sunlight, and someone says, oh, there's another wave. The second wave's coming. How are they doing it? I'll tell you how they're doing it. They're doing it because they love you. They're doing it because they love us. That's what we do. I need to put my big boy pants on. And I need to go, okay, let's go out, let's take care of these people that come here, and let's assess and make sure that the future of this tour is the best that it can be. Is that fair?
Yeah. If you were a fan in the stands tomorrow, how would you handle Masker?
Well, this is what I know, and you can correct me. Somebody please correct me here. Masker mandated indoor, the suites in the concourse and stuff.
But how would you handle it?
Me? Oh, I think you, we will. We'll show a video tomorrow. We'll shoot it here, talking that, hey, if there's people that wear masks, don't look funny at them. If there's people that don't wear masks, don't look funny at them. We're all handling this at our own speed. That's when the thought was we're coming out of this thing. But now with this new thing looming, I think you got to be smart. I would much rather see masks because I can hear you fine through this. But my thing is, I want you to have fun, right? So just respect somebody next to you that's wearing a mask and you're not, and do the same the other way around, and I think we're going to be fine.
Thank you.
What is it, sir?
Oh, Nathan.
Nathan, nice to meet you, sir.
Yeah, we've had some health officials say that people should quarantine after the concert. What do you think about that?
Oh, I don't know. I mean, it's of any gathering, right? So here's who wants to be in this seat? Nissan Stadium, 71,000 people. 10 minutes into the opening act, lightning shoots across the back so far. Yeah. Here comes your state, federal, whatever law it is. We got to get these people covered. Not wearing masks, right? Now all of a sudden those 70,000 people are inside, closed in, this close to each other, sweating because it's hot, right? Now who's going to make that call to obey one law? You just stuck them in another one that totally goes against what we're thinking. So whoever wants to make that call, help themselves. So that's the thing that I would love for all of this whole 2 years to remember. Be patient with each other. Love one another, man. This forgive one another. We're going to make wrong choices, good choices, bad choices, because we none of us have ever been through this. So I think the patience that we deal with these people and show the love, and as long as we're trying, as long as money's not driving the damn thing, and as long as me caring for you and you caring for me is driving it, then we'll make the choices that we make. Is that fair to say?
Absolutely great.
Yes, sir.
Aaron Torres with the Kansas City Star.
Hey, Aaron.
Was there ever a point of discussion of decreasing the number of people that were allowed to attend from 74,000 to maybe less than that at all?
Yeah, because the number's not that important. For me, it's still that connection. I think our problem was we had five or six already sold. So why are we allowing this stadium if you don't allow this stadium? So that's kind of the assessment part. Let's get this thing together, either shut it down to where Kansas City, Lincoln will be our last ones for this year, or let's decide to move forward. Watching football last night, it was fun to watch football last night. It was neat to see people in the stands. What are they going to do? Right? So we're kind of all in this boat together trying to make good decisions. So we'll learn off each other and try and do the best that you can. You're representing country music. Above that, you're representing your own family name, and you're representing God. So being a responsible citizen of the greatest country on the planet, right, if people gathering in mass numbers is a bad thing for us, then I need to step down, because I'm lucky enough to be one of those things that people gather in mass numbers for, and I will gladly step down as a citizen of the United States if it's better for this country. I said that in Nashville. I'll say it tomorrow. I'll say it to you. If it comes down to Garth Brooks never playing music again is the best thing for this country, I will gladly say thank you for my time. And everybody else good?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Go ahead.
How important is it that the vaccination?
You know what? Everybody's saying that's my idea. That's very sweet of them. It wasn't. These guys decided since there was a mass gathering, let's put a vaccination tent out there. I love that. Still, your choice. Me, I'm vaccinated, fully vaccinated. This tour, fully vaccinated. Anybody that wasn't and won't be vaccinated on this tour is sitting at home, getting paid. They're getting paid, but if they have a doctor's kind of thing where it's like, hey, then that's their choice. I'm not going to force you to get vaccinated to work here. That's our rules. Am I glad other companies are forcing theirs to get vaccinated to say, yes, I am. It's just not ours. So if that's fair enough to say. But my thing is, I'm vaccinated. I encourage you to get vaccinated, but until it's a law, it's a choice. And when it's a choice, it's just like who you vote for, right? I mean, it's like it's still going to be your choice, whoever that is. And we need to respect that as much as we might disagree with it. You know, one of the things that I think today, and forgive me, Aaron, because you're going to hate this next statement. One of the things is what used to be, Aaron, was we used to, I think this way, you think that way. And that's how it used to be. That's how we got along. But now it's I think this way. And now if you don't think this way, I don't like you. What do you mean? What is that, right? I mean, let's go down the rabbit hole real quick. World, global war, whatever. There's 10 people left in a bunker. Those another 9 people better pray to God Garth Brooks is not one of the 10. Because Garth Brooks doesn't know shit about energy or building diesel engines or anything to survive, right? If these people, if their life depends on the verse lifting off into the chorus, I'm going to save every one of them, right? But so let's make sure that there's an upper scale of thinking alike. Treat people the way you want to be treated. Love one another. Why are we down here on this planet? It's for each other. Then there's that second wave where you want everybody thinking as different as you can, because 100 different ideas makes the one you pick hopefully better. And I bet you 10 to 1 the one you pick wasn't the original idea. It came with idea number 99 over here changing a little bit. That's what I want. I want us to use our diversity as our strength.
And we shall be good.
Yeah, amen. Amen. Have I depressed everybody enough?
You mentioned there were discussions on whether to hold this or not. How close, can you take us inside, how close this discussion
sounds? Kansas City?
Yeah.
Well, no, because it was one of those, if it would have been, Kansas City was supposed to be the next one on sale once COVID hit. And it broke my heart because you guys were coming off a world championship. Kansas City is like, I don't know why they treat me the way they do here, but they treat me phenomenal here. It was going to be the biggest party on the planet. So the fact that it went on sale afterward, you put it on sale, you got your show, go get it done, right? Go have fun, get those people taken care of. And again, I can't apologize enough to the great cities of Charlotte and Cincinnati for dragging those on and on and on because of the pandemic. So no, you get a chance to sell and play. I think that was real important for us. Same way with Lincoln. And then that 3-week window after kind of makes you think that's where you'll make your decision because of what we talked about earlier. Is that fair?
Yes, sir.
Anybody else?
Is there a part of you that's nervous at all to be performing in front of 75,000 people all at once?
The good nervous, though. It's fun. It's exciting. What is your name, please?
Gian. I'm with KMBC 41.
Miss Gian, the whole thing is I'll be I watch. This is what I do for a living. So I'm going to be watching. From the first second, I'll be watching. But the second song of the set's always, first song's always new because that's when people can handle new with a career this long. I'm excited, new, okay, we'll have some fun. But the second one better be one of those old stuff that sends the message, we're bringing everything, right? But in that second song, if you're with me by the second line, if you take it from me by the second line, then it's no longer a concert, it's a party. If you don't take it by the second line, I'm going to work you like a rented mule till you do take it, right? Because I'm lazy. All I want to do is have fun and watch tomorrow night. I'm going to work you to death. That's the fun part of entertaining. So I'll be watching. And just so people know, bone up on your Garth stuff because you're going to be put to the test tomorrow night. I won't let you. I'll throw something at you if I think you're sleeping on me. Fair enough. Good?
We're good. We'll jump into some 101s, okay?
Thank you.
I'll take that.